Selling Homes in the World of Real Estate, Introduction. In order to revive the nearly unprofitable real estate market, it is important that more and more homes are staged. This is a simple concept that ensures that a particular house that is for sales find appeal with more and more buyers. Apart from getting a large number of buyers so that the seller can strike a good bargain, it is also equally important for the seller that his house gets sold off quickly. It is important to increase the demand so that the market can get more lucrative. This is the primary reason why real estate agents are fast hiring, or themselves turning into staging professionals. These professionals help in building homes that find maximum appeal to the seller in terms of their tastes and preferences. And it is a fact that staged homes bring as much as 15% more revenue than those that are not. People are constantly looking for a house with more space. Many look at it as an investment, that how much they will gain when they in turn sell it. Keeping all this in mind, a professional stages houses. Therefore, those people who want to sell their houses enlist the services of such staging professionals who, on being hired, help the owners to prepare their houses for sale. They are specialized to so such a job. And indeed, the sellers see the difference in the demand for their property and the price that is coming in, before and after the staging professional has done his job. Sellers generally use services of the agents who report to the seller that their house is not getting a good offer. They cannot, however, pinpoint the problem. They cannot understand the nature of renovation the house needs. Staging professionals, being specialized at these things, have a good idea of what the buyers are looking for and are effectively able to help the seller. It is true that different buyers have different tastes, but with some things one can never go wrong. And this is precisely the principle that staging professionals follow. Staging of a house is done on the fundamental belief that a well-staged house will cost money. The seller will have to pay for the renovation and the professional's fees. It will still be more profitable than reducing the selling price of your house. According to a survey, 50% of the sellers are willing to spend about $2,000 on staging, while 50% of them are willing to go up to $5,000. Staging professionals have a clear idea about the kind of colors that sell, the kind of furnishing in the house that makes it more appealing to those who come to have a look at it. They also have a clear idea of how the space inside the house must be used for optimum utility, which seems to be a major concern for all buyers. It is a fact that well showcased houses sell 84% faster than those that are not. Staging professionals are not into house building or house designing. They merely advise the agents or the sellers themselves on the strategy to use while redoing their house. Here are a few standard tools they use. Color, a tried and tested palette that professionals use can never go wrong. Though trends keep changing, but there are some basic colors that never go out of vogue. Professionals generally work with neutral colors that have a wide appeal. Furniture, professionals have just the precise idea of how to furnish and accessorize the house. Space, optimization of space must be done well and professionals can tell you how. Budget, they also work with economical budgets. And indeed, that is what the seller wants, to maximize his profit from selling his house. There are several seminars arranged from time to time from which professionals can take valuable advice. Trends keep changing from time to time, and a good professional must necessarily keep himself updated about those recent developments. On the basis of such knowledge, he can suggest to sellers or their agents what to do with their house while selling. The professional keeping himself abreast of the latest developments even increases the seller's faith in him and is a sure-shot tool of success for the professional. After all, nothing is more valuable than the professional being able to get the house sold faster for a good price. What keeps homes from being sold? Selling houses needs the agent and sellers to have a certain kind of experience. It is a fact that houses cannot always be sold on the spur of the moment. It needs proper planning, and there is always a cohesive way to go about it. One of the other hassles that those who need to sell their house need to go through are the legal and technical formalities that form such an important part of the whole process. The legal paperwork that selling a house involves is far greater than you can imagine. It needs proper professional aid. If you are capable of doing it yourself, then it is an additional advantage, but you must be very careful. Any small error in any detail that you may have provided can cost you a lot of money. The following is a basic checklist you must always refer to when you try and show your house to prospective buyers. You need to take care of these things so that you do not put them off, thwarting your chances of actually striking a good bargain. Declutter: any home with a lot of clutter, that is to say, a house that has not used up its space in a proper manner, stands very less chances of getting sold faster for a good price. More and more people these days are looking at optimizing the space within the house. Because of increasing population, the living area for most people is decreasing. So within whatever space they have, they would like to have it done well. Make beds. In case you are in a habit of leaving home each morning for work without having made your beds, you are in trouble. Your agent may bring prospective buyers to your house and they may find beds not made. This is nothing major, but it just gives a very negative impression. If you cannot make your beds in the morning, you can talk with your agent and ask him to avoid bringing in people before a particular time, or bring them only during weekends, the only time you make your bed. Clean closets. Make sure your closets and drawers are neatly arranged. It just gives an impression of order within the household. Cluttered closets symbolize chaos and give a wrong impression of your house to buyers. Light. Make sure that you have your curtains drawn to let in enough natural light. Use natural light as far as possible. Artificial lighting can be used to enhance the interiors of your house, but just relying on artificial lighting gives a gloomy impression. Leave your house, let the agents do the showing around. If someone has come to view your house that they might buy for a huge sum of money, they want to have a look at it well. In the presence of its current residents, viewers cannot frankly view the house well. They cannot open and inspect each cabinet. Clean yard. Make sure your yard is clean and tidy as well. As with beds and closets, this too plays a major role in forming a good impression. Be accessible. You may have a very erratic schedule, but you must make sure that you are available for prospective buyers whenever they have to make a phone call to you to ask you things about your house. This is one way in which you can ensure your house gets sold quickly. Untraceable owners lose many a prospect just by being inaccessible. Keep your agent or realtor abreast of the kind of schedule you follow. Dogs and pets. If you have strange fascination for weird pets, or even for something as harmless as a dog, make sure you send him for a walk. People who come to view your house may not be very impressed by your animal. On the contrary, if they do not like animals, they may feel uncomfortable and be unable to inspect your house well. Smell. Make sure your house does not stink under any circumstances. It is a major put-off. Check regularly. You must inspect your own house to see everything is in place, especially the above items. Do a regular checkup, maybe once a week. Arrange the closets, mow the yard. Make sure everything looks vibrant and happy. Never, however, give a false impression. Show your house just as it is, reflecting all the good times you have spent there. Tips on how to make a first good impression of your home. Presentation. Yes, that is the keyword you always need to keep in mind. First impression is the last impression is a proverb that not many people are willing to buy into these days. But in case of homes, especially an old home that you are showcasing to others, this may very well be the case. It is a time-tested way to make sure that your house gets liked by whoever comes to view it. To make sure that you make a good impression on the prospective buyers, you need to make sure certain things in your house are fixed. As someone living in the house, many things might be normal to you because you have gotten used to them. But to an outsider, these things are not normal. On the contrary, they are an anomaly and will immediately be noticed by them. Any crack in the ceiling, any broken piece of furniture must be fixed before you start showing your house to outsiders. The sure-shot way to find out these anomalies is to ask your agent what he finds amiss. Here's what you need to look out for. Outside. 1. Mow the grass and trim the edges. 2. Weed the garden and clean the drive. Remove the leaves. 3. The grass beds must be weeded and cleaned. 4. Shrubs must be trimmed so that they do not look untidy. 5. Wash the house from the outside. 6. Keep the garage in a neat and tidy condition. 7. Keep the back door clutter-free. You have been used to dumping all extra and unwanted items there. But now you need to pick them and put them in their proper place. Inside. Kitchen. 1. Clean taps and fitting well and make them shine. 2. Polish counters, cabinets and other furniture around your kitchen. 3. Clean the floor too. If it is high-gloss type flooring, make sure it glosses. Use a good floor polish to make that happen. 4. Cupboard doors must also be cleaned thoroughly. 5. All equipment in your kitchen must look good. Clean the casing of the refrigerator and dishwasher and any other equipment around. 6. Make sure your oven is in a good condition. 7. Make the stove top shine. You can use one of the many stove polishes available to do so. Bathroom and lavatory. 1. Taps and fittings must be taken care of. Polish and clean them. 2. Take care of the vanity unit. If it is made of high-gloss material, polish it well. 3. Lavatory seats must also be polished and cleaned well. Laundry. 1. Keep the laundry room clutter-free. You don't want it to look as dingy as you have always been used to keeping it to the prospective buyers. 2. Paint it if that needs to be done. 3. Polish the tub. 4. Make sure the washing machine is in a good condition. 5. Clean up all the extra things you have been dumping there without even realizing. Bedrooms. 1. Make beds before leaving your house each day. 2. Keep your closets and drawers tidy. 3. Be open to prospective buyers wanting to inspect them. Living room. 1. Keep it tidy. 2. Make sure the curtains and drapes are washed and tidy. 3. Potted plants that have not been taken care of must be removed. 4. Buy new one if required. Dining room. 1. Keep your table well polished. There are lots of varnishes available in the market. Invest in a good one. 2. If your table is anyway old and rusty, cover it well with a good tablecloth. 3. Place flowers and vases over it to make it look decent. 4. Get proper drapes and curtain for the dining room. 5. Keep this area clutter-free as well. General. 1. Any doors around the house must look like they are always in use. That is to say, they must be well oiled. Creaking doors give a very wrong impression to those outsiders who come to view your house. They make the viewers feel that the house has not been much in use and taken care of. You must take care of this small aspect. 2. Place potted plants wherever required. It adds glow and vibrancy to your house and also makes it look a prosperous place to live in. 3. Provide the house with good lighting so as not to make it look dull. Let as much natural light come in as possible. Quick and easy ways on how to sell your home. The omission of a middleman is perfectly justifiable if you can manage to sell your house without enlisting his help. This particular tactic is not very difficult to understand. You save a great amount of money if you do not have to pay your real estate agent his commissions for getting you buyers for your house. Moreover, by doing so, that is, removing the middleman, you can also afford to lower the price you have quoted for your house, leading to the much faster selling of the house. However, with this decision to sell your house without the help of a real estate agent means that the work to be done on your part increases. Such work for the agent is part of his daily routine as he has to encounter such formalities with every project he gets. For you, thought it may be new, it is not impossible to accomplish, and you will soon find how. The first thing an agent will do when you hire him is he will come and see your house for himself. He will need to know whether your house is in a presentable condition. Then he will go about telling you what are the things that need fixing and altering. He may even consult a staging professional at this stage. Therefore, this is the first thing you must find out for yourself too. Is your house in a presentable condition? The following are the areas you need to look out for. 1. Floors and ceiling. 2. Bathroom and kitchen fittings. 3. Lighting and ventilation. 4. Doors and windows. 5. Paint, both on the inside and outside. 6. Drainage system around the house. 7. Condition of driveway and walkway. 8. Home improvements. Besides these general outlines, you can take some forward steps to ensure that your house gets sold quickly and without much hassle. Cosmetic improvements: you can alter the design of your house a bit by repainting the wall, redoing the furniture, and optimizing the living area. You will have to keep the latest trends in mind while doing so. Taking help of a staging professional can also help here. You can make your house look inviting, as a result of which it may look impressing. You can decorate it with proper lighting and plants, etc. Basically, you need to make sure all the furniture, kitchen and bathroom cabinets and equipment, etc. are all in good condition. Target buyers, you need to know the kind of people that will be moving into your house. You need to analyze what kind of people will prefer a house in the locality in which you are now living. You can take the example of the neighbors that have just moved in. Though people differ, but some traits remain the same. Knowing your target customers will help a great deal in staging your house. Buyers' needs, people are very finicky about the kind of house they prefer and they are not wrong in thinking so. Though you cannot guess each of those small details, you can satisfy some of their broader concerns which may pertain to security of the neighborhood, connectivity with the marketplace, their workplace, their children's school, etc., and comfort. Pricing, at all costs, keep the pricing very realistic. There is no point just thinking about your own profit, because quoting such a high price would mean that your house does not get sold quickly. Have a good idea about the current real estate market condition and quote your price accordingly. Also decide on how you would like to attract buyers and what kind of advertisement would you like to place and where. Negotiate the price in terms of purchase and sale very carefully. You need to be extra careful while doing so, especially because you are not enlisting the services of a real estate agent for whom these clauses are quite normal. Legal aid, never refrain from seeking legal aid when in doubt. Rather, it is always better to hire a lawyer even if it means you will have to pay him a portion of your profits earned as fees. There are very complex land and property related issues that you might not be familiar with. You do not want to get caught unawares in case something untoward may happen.